We are going, hoping, to put in a documentary which really describes all the story how Professor Siv, Professor Aralik, all of these stories, how really we came together, how we met each other, and all of them is a full story for a full documentary. And also Richard Shaw came to the idea of the cause. Also interesting stories. I mean, all the stories behind the cause, no doubt, is divine providence. And if you see now, bring you a piece, really, of the story, how I met really Rips, and how together we did a book in Hebrew and in English. This is a book which are going to show you some samples for it. So this is exactly the book, and what you have here is Torah Code, Glimpse into the Infinite. And this is a book which myself and Professor Rips and Professor Aralik, we did together. The story is also an interesting story behind. After contact for a while between Professor Rips and Aralik, in fact, I did this contact when I met Professor Aralik, and also an interesting story in Jerusalem. And he was visiting the wedding wall, and exactly I have a book. I have my books on the window. There is a small shop there of books right on top of the hotel wailing wall, and everyone who is going to see, you know, the quarter, which they call the Rova, they are going through there. So yeah, Professor Alex went through and he saw suddenly my books in the window. Then he jumped in and said, what? I have only two books, there are more books. So by Gleason books? I said, yes, and Gleason said, oh, I want to tell you, your books are marvelous, important, and I myself, after seeing it, before the greatness of the Holy Tongue, Shona Kodesh, so seeing your books, so I wrote myself a book, and I was in Israel now, I thought I will find rabbis who will see my work, and you know, they will give me, like we call haskamat, approbation, but they told me we are not familiar with this material. So now I see I came exactly you were there. So I looked into his book, the manuscript, not the book yet, and I saw that almost every third page was my books in Judaism, about the Zodiac, the Zohar. So altogether it was an amazing book, no doubt, that he brought things together, you know, combined the ideas beautifully. And then I gave him a letter of commendation, and I told him to go to Aronson Publications in the state, and they will do it. So they saw my commendation, and they did his book, which is called The Inner Meaning of the Hebrew Letter. So, interesting story. This is I met with Professor Alex, and in fact, this is also how I came to the idea of the cause, because this is not my area. My area is Lashon HaKodesh, or about, in English, I think about 25 books about Lashon HaKodesh, different subjects, Eter Sofar, Bab Zodek, Music Kabbalah, so many more, and also in Russian came out the same 20 books, and in Hebrew, Persian, French, but this was my area, not at all cause. So when I met Professor Aralik, and he asked me to come to visit him when I was in Los Angeles giving lectures. So I came to him. So he told me that he was in a seminar, Achim Singh, and he saw the phenomena of the cause. But he thinks it is much more behind. And that's of being a professor of computer science, he built up also program exactly the same thing with the letter of the Torah, as we know, letter after letter. So he told me, so this is what I did. So I told him, show me, please, your program, and I want to see, I tell you which verse to put in, and then let us see. So it was exactly the time, I think, 1994, 5, 6, around this area. But at that time was a lot in the news about peace treaty, you know, Rabin, Peres, all this. I told him, please put Peres, put Rabin, put Jose Shalom. So I want to see when it comes. I saw when it appears in the Torah. So when I saw when it appeared in the Torah, I told him, Professor, we are writing a book. Well, yeah, writing a book about the courts. I will be here, you will be in university, half a day singing there, and then the other half a day we'll sit together and we'll find out course with this subject, topic, and so on. So I was there for about 2 months. We did a book, I think, about courts. I forgot the name, a very old book. I mean, that it was the first book that he wrote about the courts. I think the courts about Israel, so on. Then many other books came together, many other books, definitely. But this was really the beginning. Then I told him about Professor Ripso. He called Professor Ripso. The connection with Professor Ripso came. And he told me, Professor Ripso told me, this was the greatest contribution that I did to the courts, because Professor Radek known to be very, very great in this area of definitely science, you know, to be one of the great professors, you know, I can see a lot about him on the internet. But he himself has been going into this, and he really made the contact that was necessary to bring it into the scientific fields, and he helps those who are working on codes. It was a convention in Hong Kong about the science, pattern recognition, image processing, so whatever it is interesting, convention, normally was are doing it once here in different places, and normally scientists send their work, scientific work, and those who are accepted definitely are invited to this convention to give and to lecture on there. So interesting, I think at that time, as I was told, there were about 2,000 who sent their scientific work, and only 1,000 were accepted. Among these 1,000 were 7 of those who are working on the codes. So it was really a great thing, definitely. Professor Radek was organizing and so on. So this is really the story, but it's much more behind. But what I really want to tell you, a little bit later part of the story. Now, after I already had the program of the courts, I try always to find more and to do some other courts. Then, normally I'm doing it in the in the plane, you know, when maybe because it is nearer to heaven, but in fact, it is so interesting that I found sometimes there are very interesting things. Now, what I got to tell you now about is what I found. And it's really, I think, very much divine providence. Now, the first thing, what you see here, now this is in the English, the book, as I told you before, yeah, the book. What I found here, it means this is what we did with Professor Radek Ripso, myself in New York, months, as I said. And here, what you see is, you see here what is written. If you cannot see here properly, I will show in the Hebrew one, which we had, Professor Ripso, myself, did Kes Sam Lachosher into darkness. I will speak about it afterwards. But what you have here is minimal the Torah called Torah. And next to here, to this, you have language of God, because language of God is the Torah. So this is the basis of what I found afterwards. So I'm looking into it, and really many times, when I see something like this, I want to see maybe the same scheme. You have more words, and it makes the sentence longer, but maybe ideas, important ideas behind. So then I looked and I see on the same scheme, it is really 632 letters, meaning the Torah, you have the word Yachel will start. I mean, you have the sentence really Yachel Kotorah, Kotorah will start. Then the other letters down is Shem Keh, the name of God, which is the Torah. So then I thought to myself, if it's written here, Yachel Kod Torah, must be also the date. When it started, Yeah, this was here, what I did in the plains on the way to Los Angeles. Then I realized immediately, seeing clearly, parallel to it, which I showed you just now, came out there, Eight Tav Shin Lamed Vav, 5,736. I did not know much when really they started. I knew the story, right, that Rabbi Weizmendal findings were known through the lectures of Rabbi Shmuel Yaniv. Rabbi Shmuel Yaniv wrote lots of books about Sunot Batorah, he's in Kosin Zohar, in different way, mainly more on the calculations and so on. But he gave lectures and he said there is a book to Rat Chemed, Rabbi Weizmendal, and he found interesting phenomena of course. In fact, the idea of the course is really from the long time ago, you know, Rabbeinu Bechai himself, 800 years ago, from where he lived. The Rabbi Weizmendal found the idea, but there is Kabbalah, Cordovero, Moshe Cordovero, Abu Lafia, and even before, all the idea of the names of God, 72 names of God, three-letter each one, also based on verses, you know, three verses in the story of the Yom Suf, in the splitting of the Red Sea, and then there are three verses, each one contains 72 letters, if you put the 72, the three verses, one after the other, in a different way, and you cut it into three, you have 72 names of God, three letters, but it's also, in fact, Bible code, Torah code, so, but about this phenomenon, not many knew, and then Professor Ives came to Doron Witzung and told him, no, there is an interesting phenomena in the Torah codes. Then also interesting story, how they worked together, brought out statistics, science. Okay, all this will be in the documentary, but what now? Very interesting to tell you really, in short really what happened. So, when I found this, and this I want to show you really exactly how it is found, it means what I found. And this is really what you see, right? You see here, Torah code, and you can see Yachel. Yachel, each one have different color, Yachel Kod Torah, and then you have the date, 8 Tavshin Lamed Vav parallel, which is statistically, you have parallel, also very significant, no coincidence. So 8 Tavshin Lamed Vav. Now, when I gave it to Professor Ripso, he put some more words. He put the ear, the word ear on top, Shnat, and then he put Yaniv. Yaniv, this is who distributed it. It also Matai when. And Afis will be distributed. Okay. So this is what you found. And it means I found it, Yachel, but the additional of Professor Ripps. But the story is the following. The story is, so when I saw it in the plane, immediately when I came down from the plane, I picked up the phone to Professor Ripps. Tell me, Professor, when you started with Doron Witzung working on the codes, so he told me 5-5-7-3-6-1976. Okay, fine. No, I said I found a table with this date, it's called Torah. When I come to Israel, I will show you it and tell me what you can add to it. So when I came back to Israel, I went to him and I showed him the table. And then, interesting, he told me, you know, I wanted to be, that you will be sure that the date is right. So he picked out the phone, he called Rabbi Yaniv, he told me, where did you find, when we met and started working on it. So he said, 5-7-3-6, yeah, so definitely. Now, so he found it, the additional things, and then I said to Professor Ripps, you know what, let us in a book, bring a table, let us try to find out when the codes will start. It means to see whether there are indications in the Torah of the year 5736. But before this, I have to tell you an important thing, that about this date, 5736, that is Kabbalistically peace, by Rav Isaac Luria. Rav Isaac Luria, a lot of books on Kabbalah, but there is a book which is called Likutei Torah, on the portion of the week. So then, I knew it, I used to look in this book, and I remember that this date, 5736, is brought in this book on the portion on Parshat Miketz. Miketz is a portion of the Torah that we read normally on Hanukkah and the Sabbath of Hanukkah. And there we have the word telling about, right at the beginning of the portion, Vayimiketz Shnatayim Yamim, it was in the end of 2 years, days of 2 years, interesting, the expression Shnatayim Yamim. And then Joseph, you know, the whole story, Pharaoh had a dream, and he asked Joseph to interpret it. But the first verse is, Vayim Miketz Shnatayim Yamim, it was the end. So, this book of Isaac Luria, as I remember, because I looked into it because I was born exactly on Hanukkah, and this was by Bar Mitzvah, Sabbath. So I look in this book, which I had this date coming, an easy explanation which is written there. So Isaac Luria said in the book, Vayish Natayim Yamim, Shnatayim, 2 years, contains 730 days. Like in each year, you have 365. Then he adds, this is what he said, you have to add the six letters or numbers, 365, 365, and together you will have 736. And this is what he says, this is his expression. On this year, it will be Ketzayamin, the end of days, above. It means down, you will not see something clearly about the end of days of the. But this will happen on seven, this will say Ketzayamin, Yamin, end of 2 years of days. I mean, this is exactly the number, 730, 2 years, and six. The numbers. Okay. So, amazing. I saw connection between sometimes to do with the end of days and the distribution, the coming out of the codes. So, must be connection. So, I said to Professor Reeves, when, you know, preparing the book, let us see if there is some connection between this 5736, which is in Hebrew 8 Tav Shin Lamed Vav, and Ketzayamin in the end of days. Now, the sentence Ketz Hayamim Vav Lemala could not be, but Ketzayamin came out and Lemala came a little bit higher. Now, I show it in Hebrew, yeah, because it's a much clearer the picture, and then you will see Ketzayamin, the end of days, and 5736, every two letters, which is minimal in the whole Torah. Amazing. So, no doubt, clear proof that it is like this. Really, the end of this was on this year, starting, I mean, above, not yet seeing down. So look, this is a table, I will show it to you here. Here is, I think, clearer. You can see the words much clearer. So this is Ketzayamin. So what you see in green is Ketzayamin, yeah, red is Ketz and Ayamin, and next to it you can see Eitav Shid Lamed Vav. You can see Eitav 5776, and Professor Ibs points out, if you see M1, it means minimal in the old Torah. Amazing. So it's best meeting and above. So I think it's a big proof to what I really found. It means that it is really a date when the code started. And the code, by this clearly seeing this connection between Messianic time and the codes. And this also we are going up to put in the documentary, clear proofs that the codes are really connected with Messianic time. The code is a doctrine of Messiah. So all of this we are going to put in the documentary, We need still money to do it, but I think it's very, very important documentary because you could see clearly with all the stories of Richard Shaw, how he came suddenly to do a documentary on the cause. An amazing, beautiful story. And I met Professor Radek, an interesting story, and exactly finding this one and coming to, you know, to Israel and showing Professor Rips, and exactly it fits with everything. So no doubt. Then, as I said, really, my book in Hebrew, Kesam Lachoshech, I said, End to Darkness. Now, by the way, the idea of this year, 5736, 1976, which we, Rabbi Isaac Luria, basically is in the Kabbalah, in the Zohar, on this portion. The portion also brings this verse, Kesam Lachoshech, End to Darkness. And he says, definitely, this is a Kabbalistic, but it's an amazing thing that is the Kabbalah, the Zohar says. Okay, just we know a little bit of Kabbalah, I don't have to do it, I don't know a lot about it. But this is what the Kabbalah, the Zohar says. If you take the numerical value of the name Adonai, Aleph, Dalet, Nun, Yud, you write it fully. Aleph, Aleph, Lamed, Pei, which is 111. And Dalet, Dalet Lamed Tzav, 434, and Nun, Nun Vav Nun, 106, and so Aleph, Dalet, Nun, Yud, Yud, 20, come to the number 671, which is the numerical value of the Otar and Aramaic. There are a lot of secrets behind, we're not going through it now, but the number of full name of God, Adnut, Mastership, Israeli Kingdom, come to 671. Then the Zohar carries and said, but in order to get a full picture of this name, you have to add the simple gematria. I mean, only letters, not the full one, like Aleph, huh? But Aleph, Dalet, Nun, Yud, you come to 65. 671 plus 65 comes to exactly 5736. Right? Amazing. So the Zohar says, it means it comes to 736, right? 5,000 is a millennia, but it comes to 736. Yeah? And the millennia is 5-6 millennia is against our time, we say definitely. Vilna Gaon says. But exactly the same number, it means the full number of Adon, which is the master kingdom, which is the sphere of kingdom, which come to, also the meaning of it is, in Aramaic, Tara is gate, a lot to discuss about it. But if you take this number fully of the letters, which is 671, plus the simple one, Aleph Dalet Yud, 736. Now the millennia, as always we speak about the time of Messiah, definitely it is this millennia, 5,000 plus, right? So the Zohar, and Rabbi Isaac Luria speak about this date, and this is the date when the courts were distributed by Professor Ibsen Doron Wilson. Could not be coincident. As I said, there are many others, beautiful tables we have with Richard Shaw about it. And all this will come in the documentary, which I hope that we'll be able to bring out, because I think it's very, very important to know, because this show how all the story of the cause is divine providence. Now I want to bring you another piece, also, I think very, very important, and again also showing clear connection to Kabbalah of the cause. So this is what Doron Wilson found, really. He brings it in his site. You have the site in the internet. I think it is torahcodes.com. So then I show you in English and then in Hebrew what he found and what I found in his finding, which really added a lot to the idea that you heard before. Now, I bring you now in English what he found, which is like this. Also difficult to see, but I will show it in Hebrew and you will see it better. So he found here, Iru beberur, they will see clearly, and Eden code in my Torah. Yeah, very interesting. Minimum the Torah, Iru beberur, they will see clearly, because Iru beberur, really this is fits with what is written in the prophecy, Ein b'ein Iru, future they will see, eye with eye, clear things. So this is what is written there, Iru beberur, Sofen chabu Eden code in my Torah. Okay, this is what he found. Now I show it in Hebrew now, that it will be better seen, and I will explain to you exactly what you have here also in the number of codes. I mean, the number of letters in this code. So this is very, very important because it adds a lot to what I found before. So let us see now this table, what Doron Witzung found, and then you will see what I found additional to it, and definitely adding a lot to the story. So this is really what Doron Witzung found, as I told you, so this is really the first chapter in our book with Professor Rips, End to Darkness, Kam de Choshech. In fact, what is written in Hebrew, it is interesting quotes, and on top, this is myself and with Professor Rips, and also tables which were to do with Professor Aralik. So, in Hebrew, Ketzam Lachoshech, and I said very interesting books that with Professor Rips 13 years ago. Yeah, 13 years ago, a little bit. Not like today that we have so many more proofs about the cause which Rips found, which is unbelievable. Yeah. Which I showed even now, the table that is 15 to 10 million about the three boys who were kidnapped and killed by Hamas, by terrorists. This one, by the way, no, this one also very early statistic, but the 15 in 10 million was a story of Bombay, the house of Chabad, clearly coming out there, the whole story. Amazing phenomena, as you see. Beit Chabad came with Bombay, and amazing. In fact, this is Dr. Katz found it, and by the way, I know we met him just at that time, and he showed that he found before. It means he found, because the story is like this, that when he heard the news, immediately he looked in the program, but there's some indication. Then it came out as, you can see it in the Professor Rips, it is in Hebrew, really. And we did it also, in fact, in the segments that we did. In fact, I did it also. Comes out the bullet which killed the couple, Olsberg. Rabbi Olsberg was exactly in the same place that it was found. And when Professor, this was Dr. Rips, told me, told the people then, he told that before he wanted to know, they did not know what happened to the rabbi and his wife. They knew about this attack, but immediately he could see the place when this story about the sons of Aaron who died, he was very worried, and he was right. Afterwards, it was found out. So it's very interesting. And this table, in fact, which Rips spoke about in the University, Bar-Ilan University, in scientific convention, he brought it. One can see it. It is in Hebrew. I will be. In fact, I did also in English, right? And about amazing finding, yeah. And to find a table like this, 15 to 10 minutes, can be there is something behind. So, what we see here is the following. Now I can see, I hope you can see clearer. Yeah, let us see. Now put it like this, it will be clearer. So here what you see is, Iru beverur, they will see clearly. This is in red, and then in blue, Sofen Chabu in the green Torati. Now, the skip is, if you can see here, it is 49 Sofen Chabu. In code, every 49 letters, and Yeruba Veru, they will see clearly coming every 50 letters. Right, 50 letters, Yeruba Veru, and 49 in. Then, when I saw this, exactly the same thing, the same story, like I found Torah Code we start. So I decided, okay, let us see what are the letters after the skip of the Rohan Wisdom. When I saw it, and when I showed to Professor Reeves, we almost both jumped from the table. Why? Look why. So, this is what Rohan Wisdom found. And then what, when I counting the 50 letters, afterwards, came here, as you can see here, Iru beveru yesh, they will see clearly that there is, yesh, there is. Okay, so then I told Professor Reif, look what I found, interesting. But what is this letter yesh? In which verse? Vayi miketz shnatayim yamim. Exactly, it was miketz shnatayim yamim, which is exactly what I found connecting to the ear of the codes. Come here exactly, that they will see clearly that there is codes, and where is indicated miketz shnatayim yamim. Keshnatayim, shnatayim yamim, on the year A, Tavshin Lamed Vav, 5736. It can be coincidence. Then I said to Professor Reeves, let us see if the date A, Tavshin Lamed Vav, appears here. Now, so look what happens. So you have here Tavshin Lamed Vav, A, Tavshin Lamed, I think three times. Yeah, three times that I see. Let us see, yeah. One on top and two on the bottom. Yeah. You can see two on the bottom. Tavshin Lamed Vav and on top. Three times. You know, we have a principle, three times is chazaka. You know, if something appears three times, it means it is true. So this is what you see, unbelievable. So now that I have the Hebrew book, you know, so I want to show you the same tables you saw in English, but they're not so clear. So I think it will be clear when you see it here. So let us see here. So this is what really I found in the plane and the additional of Professor Reeves. Now you can see it, really, I think, much better, nicer in Hebrew. And this is what you see. You see here, Yachel. Each bird is in different color. Yachel, Kod, Torah, Kod Torah will start, Shem Yud K is the name of God, it's in the Torah. Then, what I found is also parallel, you see, Eight Tavshin Lamed Vav, light blue, you can see Eight Tavshin Lamed Vav. And then Professor Reeves added these findings, at Shnat, the year, and Matai, when, and Yaniv, in green, Yaniv, and then Afis, it will be distributed, unbelievable. Yeah, so here read what you find. So, all together, as I said, now this is what I told you about. Now, it is really a small part of a documentary that we want to do. In fact, you know, I see here another additional thing that Professor Reeves put to my finding. And this is the area when it was found. It was found in the area of the Tower, Babylon, Tower of Babylon, when all the languages were mixed up. You know, before they spoke the holy tongue, you know, before all spoke the Hebrew tongue, I mean, Lashon HaKodesh, the holy tongue, only after, you know, what happens there, so God mixed the languages. So, in fact, here it tells you that Ishlel Shono, and it is a language of God. This what you have in this table. And again, Yavin, the people will understand. So, here what you see here, also called Torah, as you said. And you have the Yavinu, they will understand the language, Lashon of God. Yeah, amazing. So, as I said, we'll finish here, or we can carry on. But really, it's very, very important what you saw now, this lecture. I wish that you will repeat it and see how much divine providence in it. And as I said, the whole story of the cause is divine providence. The story of Richard Shaw meeting exactly his partner in the God, exactly met him on the plane when he missed the one plane. It means no explanation to all this, what is happening from the time that met Professor Alex there in my shop there opposite the wedding world. So all these things are really far, far from being coincidence. And many other quotes that we have clear proof that it is really part of the revelations, discoveries before the time of Messiah. And we have also, I did with Professor Reeves, Professor Haralik, quotes in which we have the doctrine of Messiah, and we have many interesting connections of this code in the time of Messiah. All show that we are near, but apparently what we need to do is still tshuva, repentance. So I think a very important documentary. This is going to be not a documentary now, but the idea of the community is very important, but we need people to help. Yeah, Baruch Hashem, for the first one, we were lucky to get a nice fellow. In fact, as you can see in the part of it, and he really, when he heard it was a convention which took place in Orlando, and Richard showed the people what are the codes, and he asked for 30,000 to start with, and a man picked up his hand, I think, a story about like this, and he gave donation, check of 30,000, he said, I don't need anything, I don't want anything for you, I don't need, I am Baruch Hashem, but when you do the documentary, put my name there in the beginning, so you see in the beginning of the documentary his name. This is very lucky to start with the first one, Torah code and to darkness, which is very important. To show the codes, it's really rabbis very much recommend to distribute this, because this is a clear proof that we are from heaven, all that. We see Professor Michelson from Harvard became Orthodox Jew because of this. Dr. Rosenberg, that we are using his program, became Orthodox because of this. So it means this is important. People believe in the Torah, yeah, the Torah is from heaven. And the Torah is a blueprint of creation. I say it works only in the Torah. The codes work only in the Torah, because they're all stories, like I showed you, can appear only in the Torah, will never appear in the Bible, let me not know, right? Not in books. Because what you find sometimes, they try to show where it's connected, but where it's here and where, but never you find a full description, which, like Trump, you know, I found Trump before, why I was sure 3 months before that he will be elected, and in fact you can see it in television, if you put a rabbi predicted Trump bill, we see exactly how you found it. Well, I was so sure, you know. I spoke in the radio, said it will be 72 letters if you put the 72, the three verses, one after the other, in a different way, and you cut it into three, you have 72 names of God. And then Joseph, you know, the whole story, Pharaoh had a dream, and he asked Joseph to interpret it.